all the operation that you perform with DAX Optimizer can be automated. Yes, you can automate the extraction of a VPAX file from a model and the analysis with DAX Optimizer. And you can do that with command line tools that can be executed not only on Windows, but also on Linux and on Mac OS. Yes, these tools are available on any platform, and they are designed to automate the operation. For example, if you have a system where you automatically deploy in production new version of the model, and you want to control whether the new version of the model satisfies all the conditions, including not having performance issues that could have been detected by DAX Optimizer. We call this way of operating DevOps, and so these command line tools have been designed to be part of a DevOps pipeline, if you want. So let's take a look at the two tools that are part of this way of working. The first one is the VPAX tool that extracts the information of the VPAX file from a model that you could have in Power BI or Analysis Services. We can see in this window that the execution of the tool that we executed before recording the video in a command line window, we have this VPAX file that has been extracted and stored locally in a temporary folder in this machine in this case, but if you automate this on the cloud, it will be a local storage for the execution of the pipeline, for example. The second step is connecting to DAX Optimizer, upload a VPAX file, and execute the analysis. The second step is executed by a second tool, which is the DAX Optimizer tool. Again, these two tools can be executed on any platform. They are written in .NET, but they are cross-platform and they are available in for different operating systems. So when you run DAX Optimizer, of course, you need to authenticate the user because you have to provide the license to execute the operation and also the result of the operation. Even though the result is returned to the command line tool, the result is also stored in the workspace that you have in the cloud, because in that storage you can also have all the information about the issues that have to be ignored, for example. So the access token that you have to obtain from the user interface of DAX Optimizer must be used in a command line tool to authenticate the execution, to authenticate the user, let's say the system user, that will execute the analysis on behalf of the group that has the license that you have to assign to a group in order to use this feature. So once you complete this analysis, what happens? The result is returned to the DAX Optimizer in a form of JSON file, and DAX Optimizer can evaluate what to do. So you can decide that in presence of issues, you stop the deployment, or you only allow the deployment when there are no issues detected, for example. But of course, the availability of this information provides you the ability to make different decisions based on the policies that you want to implement in your company.